Go Memphis Live continues with your host, Amy Spiropoulos.
Did you know that you can get shingles in your eyes? You can, and it can cause severe damage to your eyes, including scarring, vision loss, and other long-term problems. Joining us to talk about it and what you can do to prevent it is Dr. Penny Asbell, director of the UT Hamilton Eye Institute. Good morning, Dr. Asbell. Thank you so much for being here.
Jessica, it's a pleasure to be here, and it's a pleasure to share some knowledge about shingles. It's something we really don't want to get, you know?
Absolutely. That's the first thing I said this morning. Sounds painful. Uh-huh. Sounds like something I don't want. Let's start broad. What is shingles and how can it get in your eyes?
Well, it's actually a virus. It's the same virus that causes chickenpox, which most of us have had as children, or maybe we had a vaccine, depending on your age. But later on, as we grow up, we might get shingles. Shingles involves only one part of the body, but if it involves the face, it can involve the eye too. They estimate maybe there are 1 million cases a year of shingles, so it's really quite common.
And it's a lot of people that it's affecting. What kinds of complications does shingles in or near the eye cause?
Well, what happens is when you get the eye involved, you might actually affect the eye itself and lose vision. You can get an infection on the surface of the eye or even on the inside. And it happens, the bad part, not only does it happen once, but once you happen, it can recur over and over again.
So what can you do for this? What kind of treatments can you find and what can you do to make it better?
Yeah, so the key thing to remember is you really want to get the vaccination. And there's a new one out called Shingles, which works really, really well.
Okay, and what does it do?
Well, it's not a live virus, which is good to know.
Good.
You get 2 injections, which makes it a little bit more difficult to get it all done. You get one, and two or more months later, you get the second one. So ask your doctor about Shingles. It's now approved for people who are 50 and older, and it's certainly better to take it than not. The data suggests if you have the vaccine, you have 90% likelihood of not getting the shingles, and you want to avoid it. But here's something else that's going on. We're looking at people who have had shingles, have had the eye involved, and what can we do to prevent it from it being a continuing problem. So we're involved in a clinical trial called ZEDS, zoster eye disease, to try to prevent that eye disease. So if somebody out there has shingles and has the eye involved, please contact me. We'd be happy to see if we can help make their eye better. That's number one. And make sure they don't get it again.
You want to make sure that they don't get it to start. And
definitely.
Then if they do get it, though, what are some of the, is this a long-term thing? I mean, how long
it
are we talking about
term.
With the effects of shingles?
If you look at the data, almost 2/3 of people will end up having recurrent disease. That's the problem. It's not just getting it one time, it's getting it over and over. It gets better, then it acts up again, then it gets better and acts up again. And that's where they end up with permanent vision loss in that eye, which obviously nobody wants. So the key is, one, get that vaccine. And two, if you do have eye involvement, we'd love to hear from you. Maybe we can come up with a way to prevent it happening again.
And so is it those clinical trials, is that the main research that you guys are, do you use those clinical trials as your main source of research to try and figure out how to prevent?
Yeah, clinical trials are the way to go forward. So we have the state of the art of how we treat today, but if we want the next step, it's really through a clinical trial, determining not what would be the best treatment. And we always do it when we don't have the answer. If we have the answer, we just do the treatment right now. But a clinical trial, and that's really where Hamilton Eye Institute comes in, being on the cutting edge of new treatment. So I'm delighted to be here in Memphis. It's a great town and a great eye institute, and we really not only provide quality care, but the opportunity to provide the next step, the future of eye care, not just for people in Memphis, but worldwide. So it's really a wonderful place to be. I'm really happy to be here.
And what kind of progress, I guess, have you seen made? Is this a recent amount of progress? Has this been going on for a very long time in terms of the actual shingles in the eyes?
So what's interesting about shingles is actually it's much more common than it used to be. If you look over the last 60 years, we see it 4 times more often than we used to 60 years ago. People thought that was because maybe people were getting vaccines or children and people, younger people like that. But actually it's been increasing and we don't really know why. So that's another reason to get that vaccine so you're not one of the statistics. And we often think about it as a disease in people who are immunocompromised, like on cancer treatment or something like that, or had a kidney transplant or whatever. But actually it can happen in healthy people as well. So all of us want to protect ourselves to make sure we don't get it again.
And trying to be on that cutting edge. For one more time for people at home, where can they find you?
Hamilton Eye Institute. They can reach me at 901-448-1911. 448-1911. We're delighted to see people here in Memphis and help take care of them. It's been a pleasure to be here, Jessica.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Dr. Asbell. The UT Hamilton Eye Institute is located at 930 Madison Avenue on the second floor. And for even more information, you can go to universityclinicalhealth.com for more. Dr. Asbell, thank you so much.
Thank you, Jessica.
Here.
Great to be here today.
Thank you. Coming up, we are live back at Crosstown Concourse giving you a look at their upcoming performances this month. That's next.